Headlines in a moment. First tonight, though, we're getting some rare insight into a classified briefing from somebody who was there and part of it. I'm Doug Dunbar. Afghanistan was the focus of this briefing today. It is the biggest foreign affairs crisis yet for President Joe Biden. He says the United States is on track to get all Americans and U.S. allies out of Afghanistan by a looming deadline. But there's a complication tonight. The Taliban is blocking the path to the airport for evacuations, citing people's safety and the risk of stampedes. Congresswoman Beth Van Duyne warns that what's happening in Afghanistan, she says, will get worse before it gets better. While she can't share certainly everything that was discussed, she told our J.D. Miles that lawmakers from both parties left this meeting frustrated.
We are currently on a pace to finish by August the 31st. The sooner we can finish, the better.
President Biden's claim that the U.S. is on track to evacuate Americans from Afghanistan by the end of the month had some members of Congress who were part of a classified briefing call it unrealistic.
It was a frustrating meeting. I think what you saw actually was there was a lot of frustration on both sides of the aisle. You had Democrats and Republicans that were pushing back on this arbitrary August 31st deadline.
House Representative Beth Van Duyne, whose district includes Irving, was limited on what she could disclose about the meeting. But she says there's grave concerns about $85 billion worth of abandoned U.S. military equipment winding up in the hands of the Taliban.
The Taliban has access to more Black Hawk helicopters than 85% of the countries across the planet. That's what we're dealing with. And the response to that was, well, they may not have the expertise to know how to fly them.
President Biden acknowledged that a new offshoot of ISIS is gaining traction in Afghanistan now that the U.S. is leaving.
Every day we're on the ground is another day we know that ISIS-K is seeking to target the airport and attack both U.S. and allied forces and innocent civilians.
A number of those innocent civilians are trying to get to North Texas, among other places. But there are conflicting reports about whether the Taliban is working with the U.S. or blocking access to the airport in Kabul. Congresswoman Van Duyne says the White House wasn't able to provide an estimate on how many people still need to be evacuated.
The question was asked. The question was not answered.
Van Duyne says the Taliban now has biometric information on who supported American troops, putting more pressure on the U.S. to act fast. J.D. Miles, CBS 11 News. So